Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to our Maundy Thursday service. We come together tonight to remember Jesus's last few days on this earth, to remember how he gathered with the disciples and the meal he shared with them, and how he washed their feet as a servant. We also remember the commandment that he gave us to love one another. I pray that during this time tonight, it would be a time of reflection for all of us as we enter into this end of Holy Week. Let us worship.
We have come into this place to survey the wondrous cross and to contemplate the events of Holy Week. Let us hear again the Holy Scripture and story of God's loving plan and purpose in the suffering of Christ to redeem us from sin and death. Holy Week started with the triumphal entry into Jerusalem with shouts of Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. This was followed by Jesus teaching in the temple and being challenged by those in authority. He knew what lay before him, but Jesus faithfully followed his Father's will as the shadow of the cross weighed heavily on him. Let us pray that we may be transformed anew as we remember Christ's humiliation, and that we may be taught obedience as we remember Christ's obedience until death. May we love one another as Christ showed love for all people.
Thank you.
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Then came the day of unleavened bread on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. Jesus sent Peter and John saying, "Go and make preparations for us to eat the Passover." "Where do you want us to prepare for it?" they asked. He replied, "As you enter the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house that he enters and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks, where is the guest room where I may eat Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a huge, large room upstairs, all furnished. Make preparations there." They left and found things just as Jesus had told them. So they prepared the Passover.
This table, come and dine, feast on bread. we prepare our hearts to come and partake of this holy meal which Christ instituted on this night. Just a reminder, this is not Bible's table. This is not a United Methodist table. This is the table of the Lord. And Christ invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sins and seek to live in peace with God and one another. So the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right, a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. From the earth you bring forth bread and create fruit of the vine. You formed us in your image, delivered us from captivity, and made covenant to be our sovereign God. You fed us manna in the wilderness and gave grapes as evidence of the promised land. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and we join in their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. When we had turned aside from your way and abused your gifts, you gave us and him your crowning gift. Emptying himself that our joy might be full, he fed the hungry, healed the sick, ate with the scorned and forgotten, washed his disciples' feet, and gave a holy meal as a pledge of his abiding presence. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. He gave thanks to you. He broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this as often as you eat it in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as oft as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of our faith, that Christ has died,
Christ is risen, and Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we might be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes again in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever.
Amen.
And now with the confidence, as the children of God, let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Just a few words of instructions as my helpers come to join me today. We're going to partake at the ends of these aisles here, and then you can process back down the next aisle, and there you'll find a receptacle to place the cups after you've partaken. Come, let us keep the peace.
After the meal with his disciples in the upper room, Jesus walked with them. He said, "You will all desert me this very night." So it is written by the prophet Zechariah, strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. Peter told him, even if everyone falls away because of you, I will never fall away. Truly I tell you, Jesus said to him, tonight, before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times. Even if I have to die with you, Peter told him, I will never deny you. And all the disciples said the same thing. Then Jesus came with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he told the disciples,
While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him. Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus replied, "Do what you came for, friend." Then the men stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus knew the charges placed against him were false, but he continued to willingly walk the path he was called to walk, knowing the cross was nearer than ever before.
Thank you.
And when Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit.
At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from the top to the bottom. The earth shook, the rocks split, and the tombs broke open. When the centurion and all those with him who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, "Surely he was the Son of God."